Good afternoon. If you could remain standing for the singing of the National Anthem by members of the Buffalo State Chamber Choir, which is directed today by Associate Professor of Music, Ricky Fleming. And the colors today are presented by the Buffalo State College University Police Honor Guard.
Detail, halt! Left, face! Freeze and halt!
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's stripes and bright stars through the perilous night, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air,
please be seated. Good evening. I'm Pete Grum, and as a member of the Buffalo State College Council, I have the privilege this evening to declare this 144th commencement of Buffalo State College officially convened. I would like to welcome each of you to the 2016 commencement ceremony, and I extend my congratulations to all the graduates. I will now introduce the members of the platform party, and I ask them to stand as I call their names. Could you please hold your applause until everyone's been introduced? Our mace bearer, Heidi Dietz Folletti, Associate Professor Emerita, English. SUNY's Chancellor Award for Student Excellence recipient, Kenise Adams. recipient of the President's Medal for Outstanding Graduate Student and the SUNY Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence, Ashley Weslack. Ms. Weslack is also the student speaker for this commencement ceremony. Graduate Association President Christine Matos, the Academic and Administrative Deans of Buffalo State, the Buffalo State President's Cabinet, Buffalo State Provost Melanie Perot, Buffalo State College Council members Todd Brayson and Melissa Brinson, Alumni Association President Richard Trigolo, Class of 1990, New York State Region and Keynote Speaker Catherine Collins, and the President of this fine university, Buffalo State College, Catherine Conway Turner. And I'd also like to thank Associate Professor Roger Feirstein from our International Center for Studies and Creativity for serving as our announcer this evening, as well as Tom Kohler from the Athletic Department, who will read our graduates' names. Please, all of you, acknowledge our platform party. I would like to now ask the President of Buffalo State College, Dr. Catherine Conway Turner, to offer her welcome remarks.
Well, greetings to the families, friends, alumni, honored guests, and especially the class of 2016. Oh, yeah. And a special greeting to students who are completing their online adult education graduate degrees and are participating in today's ceremony remotely from across the country. On behalf of the faculty and staff at Buffalo State College, good evening and welcome again to our 144th annual graduate commencement exercises. Graduates, I know that this is a day that you have anticipated for some time. I'm sure there were moments when you thought this day might not come or was further away in the future than you planned. But here we are, celebrating your accomplishments with enthusiasm and pride as you prepare to move on to the next phase of your lives. Congratulations, you have successfully completed your graduate degrees and certifications. You represent some of the best and brightest of the world and today's graduates, and you're coming from nearly 18 different countries. Many of you accomplished this while juggling other responsibilities, such as careers and children and family and community commitments. You have each made hard decisions and personal sacrifices to arrive at this destination. You have had help along the way from faculty and staff and family and friends and mentors and fellow classmates. We are all extremely proud of you. We hope that while you have been here, you have cultivated a better understanding of your talents and the ways to apply them. We believe your Buffalo State degree has prepared you for a lifetime of successes and leadership roles. Each of you has completed significant and important projects as a part of your degree requirements. For example, Christine Parker finished her master's in museum studies by completing an exhibition and a documentary film during her years here at Buffalo State. And Crystal Holmes Smith, in the literacy specialist program, traveled to Rwanda and blogged about her experiences. And Matthew Cadeus, in biology, examined dependent grassland plant species. Now, what is common for each graduate receiving their degree today is that they deeply examined important issues and are poised to advance professionally as they complete their studies. For all students, this ceremony marks a milestone in your academic and professional careers. When you leave this auditorium, you will be among 12% of the U.S. population that hold a master's degree. And when you consider that just short of 7% of the world population holds any kind of college degree at all, your achievement is even more significant. You are now poised and prepared to keep pace with a changing world. You are more able than ever to make a substantial contribution to all avenues of your life. You have a clear sense of your career direction and professional place in the world. You are better able to serve your profession, your community, your family, and yourself. Commencement seems like an ending, but it is really a beginning, the beginning of the next chapter of your lives. We hope you have found your time at Buffalo State fulfilling and intellectually enriching. You have met people who will remain important to you for the rest of your life. You've learned lessons that will be of value for you always, and we hope that you will stay in touch with your alma mater and come back to visit us often. I look forward to hearing of your future successes as you build on the firm foundation of your Buffalo State College graduate education. Again, congratulations to the class of 2016, and welcome to all. We are very fortunate to be joined by United States Senator Charles Schumer. A recent schedule change made it possible for him to be here with us briefly this evening. Over the past 3.5 decades as a senator, United States Representative, and State Assemblyperson, Charles Schumer has been a leader on state and national issues and a tireless fighter for New York. Throughout his time in the Senate, Senator Schumer has made improving New York's economy his top priority. We are delighted that he is able to join us today, and I invite him to extend greetings. Please join me in welcoming United States Senator Charles Schumer.
Well, thank you, President Conway Turner, and thank you for the outstanding job you are doing here as the new, well, two-year president of Buff State. It's my honor to address the members of the platform party, the friends and families of the graduates, but most of all, you, the class of 2016 Buff State. Congratulations. Now, first, I'd like to announce my class gift. As you know, it's hard to pay for college and graduate school. If you're poor, the federal government helps you out. That's a good thing. But what about the middle class? So a few years ago, I wrote a law that said you or your parents, who's ever paying for graduate school, can take as a full tax credit $2,500 off your federal taxes to help defray the cost of tuition, provided — there's always a provided in Washington — provided your family income is below $200,000 a year. So, for those of you who come from families who make below $200,000, make sure you take that credit. And by the way, if you just recently graduated from college, it applies to college as well. About 25% of the people who are entitled forgot to do it last year. And if you're one of those families, you can file an easy one-page form with the IRS and get up to $7,500 back 3 years. You can go 3 years back. So that's not a bad class gift. Now, but what happens if you come from a family that makes above $200,000 a year? God bless you. I'd like to congratulate the moms and dads in the audience. I know how you feel. A few short years ago, my wife Iris and I sat where you did and watched our daughter Jessica come up and get her diploma. It was one of the greatest days of our lives. And if you're like us, you know, it's not easy raising kids. You probably think back to some of the tougher times. We remembered when Jessica was 5 months old. She had a 106.5 fever. We rushed her to the hospital. We didn't think she'd make it. Praise God she did. We remembered when we put her on the kindergarten bus for the first time when she was 5. And as the bus pulled away, she ran to the back of the bus, waved goodbye out the back window, tears streaming down her little cheeks. But when Iris went to meet her on the bus's return, she bounded off the bus as happy as could be at 2 o'clock. She said, "Mommy, I came back." When we talked to her that night, we realized what was in her little head. She thought that was it. New parents, new family, new room, new house, new toys. Then we remember Jessie as a teenager, when she didn't say much to us. And when she did, we didn't understand a word she said. And then, moms, dads, you see your daughters and sons come up on the stage here and get that diploma and become an adult before your very eyes. Congratulations to the moms and dads out there. And finally, one more note of thanks. As we're having a great time here tonight at graduation at Buff State for graduate school, there are men and women, your age graduates, who are in our armed forces, many from Western New York. We have a proud tradition of volunteering here. And they're overseas in dangerous places, risking their lives for our freedom. Let's have a round of applause for them as well. Okay, so to this great class of Buff State 2016, you know, you're graduating with a bunch of gifts. First, as the president mentioned, very few people have the degrees you have. You have a leg up educationally on almost all other Americans your age. Very few get graduate degrees, only a third get college degrees, and you're graduating from an institution that has prepared you extremely well, Buff State. Another gift are your families, whether it be your parents or your spouses or your kids. They'll stand behind you through thick and thin. And there's another gift you have, and that is you're really the first generation to grow up amidst all of this new technology. 1988, maybe a few of you were born in that year. That was the first year the word internet was ever used in print. There was no Google and no Facebook and no Instagram, no emojis, no hashtags, no LOL. In 1994, when some of you were born that year, many of you were toddlers, there were only 13 websites on the World Wide Web. That's it, 13. Now there's 15 billion, and that shows you how rapidly technology is changing our world. And you know, your parents, your teachers, me, we're the older generation. We try to get with it with this technology, but it's hard for us. We're learning it as adults. But for you, it's a natural. You were born into it. Technology is to your generation like water is to a fish. You've been swimming in it your whole lives. So the fact that you've gotten a great degree here at Buff State and a great education, the fact that you've got families who will always have your back, and the fact that you're the first generation to be instinctively immersed in this new technology means one thing. Now is the time, if there ever was one, to figure out what your dream is. Reach high for it, even if it seems a hard reach. Then, reach deep down inside yourself. See what you're made of. See if you can achieve that dream. My advice to the class of 2016 is very simple. Go for it. Now, yeah, thank you. Now, sometimes you'll make the wrong choice, but if my experience is any indication, you'll pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and move forward. But if you make the right choice, with a lot of hard work, a little luck and some prayer, your life will be enriched forever. Now, I learned these lessons myself. When I was seated at graduation from college many decades ago, I learned that I had just won a scholarship to travel all around the world, all expenses paid, for a whole year. For me, it was the opportunity of a lifetime. I had never been out of the country before. But at the same time, I met a girl, and I fell in love. Aww. Well, graduates, I had to decide. Do I go around the world on the all-expense-paid scholarship for a whole year? Or do I stay home with the girl, my first true love? What would you have done, class of 2016? Madam President, the class is divided. I stayed home with the girl. No, don't applaud yet, the romantics over there. The story continues. That summer, she went on a brief vacation, and I went to the airport to meet her on her return. As soon as she got off the plane, I saw by the look on her face something was the matter. She dumped me by Labor Day. There I was, no scholarship, no trip around the world, no girl. I said to myself, what a loser you are. You're never gonna make anything of yourself. Hang it up, forget it. And in fact, I stayed in my house for several months, moped around, felt sorry for myself. But somehow I picked myself up, dusted myself off, and moved forward. And a few years later, I found myself seated at graduation from graduate school from law school. But on the way home from law school, I told Mom and Dad that I was not going to join the fancy law firm like we had planned. I told them I loved politics. I told them my dream was to run for office, even though the chances of winning were remote. My parents, as you could understand, were shocked. My mom was particularly disappointed. You see, I grew up in a working-class family. They struggled to send me to college and law school. My father was an exterminator, didn't go to college, didn't make any money. And the law firm was paying $400 a week, which in those days was more money than my family had ever seen. But my dream was to run for office. And so that fall, at the age of 23, and against very long odds, I ran for the New York State Assembly, and I had three opponents. There was the party machine candidate. There was a neighborhood activist. And then there was my mother, who was telling all her friends not to vote for me. So as she said, I'd get this dumb idea of being a politician out of my big, thick head. Well, graduates, a few years earlier, I sure didn't get that girl. But that November, I won the election. So, to this great class, Buff State 2016, go for it. And remember, you have three gifts, at least three gifts. A great education with your degree here from Buff State. Families that are going to always have your back, and an instinctive knowledge of this new technological world we're in. In conclusion, it is my hope. It is my prayer, and indeed it's my confidence that you will use those three gifts wisely, use them well, and achieve your dream. To this great class of 2016, congratulations. Good luck. Godspeed. And don't forget, go for it.
Well, thank you, Senator Schumer, for those remarks, and thanks for being such a good friend to Buffalo State College. This year, a number of our students, both graduate and undergraduate students, have been honored by the State University of New York with the Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence. The Chancellor's Award is the highest honor bestowed by the State University of New York upon a student. This award recognizes model students who have integrated academic excellence with achievements in areas such as athletics, community service, creative and performing arts, entrepreneurship, leadership, and career achievement. These students were formally recognized by Chancellor Nancy Zimpher in Albany last month. At Buffalo State, it has been our long-standing tradition to present these fine students to the faculty, staff, and their fellow students at commencement. It is my pleasure to acknowledge two of our honored students at this ceremony. You will find a full description of each student's accomplishments in your program. These awards bring distinction to the recipient and honor to Buffalo State. Would Kenise Adams please come forward? Today, Kenise receives a Master's of Science degree in Higher Education and Student Affairs Administration. Her overall GPA is 4.0. She brings a critical inquiry perspective to all of her work, and she uses her strong quantitative and writing skills to explore issues of professional development, social justice, and socioeconomics. Kenees is particularly passionate about international students and their experiences. After learning of the struggles of international students while working at the International Student Services Office at Buffalo State, she conceived of and developed the college's International Student Mentoring Program to assist first-year international students in their transition to campus. On campus, Ms. Adams has demonstrated leadership as an active role as a chair of the Professional Development Committee of the Graduate Association of Student Personnel Administrators, and as a resident director, supervising 20 resident assistants. She is a poised leader whose care and commitment to the success and successful development of students is evident in her dedicated work as a scholar and a professional. We are proud to honor Kenees Adams as a recipient of the SUNY Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence. Congratulations. And now, I ask Ashley Westlake to come forward. In addition to recognizing Ashley for her Chancellor's Award, we are also extremely proud to recognize our student speaker for this evening's commencement ceremony with the highest graduate student award given to Buffalo State College, the President's Medal for an Outstanding Graduate Student. Ashley is graduating today with a Master's of Science in an education degree in English education, attaining a 3.96 GPA while excelling in campus leadership roles and representing her school in unique international experiences. Ashley is a valued ambassador for the college and its graduate programs. In 2015, she was selected as the first student from the School of Education and the first non-theater student to participate in the theater department's Anne Frank Project service trip to Rwanda. She shared drama-based education practices for teacher trainers at the Wellspring Foundation for Education, and later presented her findings about drama-based education in Rwanda to the National Association for Professional Development Schools. In prior education trips, she has also visited England, Ireland, Italy, and Poland. She was named a lead graduate student on a research project conducted through the Woods Beall Endowed Chair in Urban Education at Buffalo State, and she also served her fellow students as a senator in the Graduate School Association. As AmeriCorps volunteer, she worked as the head teacher of an English as a second language program. Ashley is adept at teaching, leading, and inspiring people. Her consistent performance and attitude make her an ideal teacher. For these reasons, I am pleased and proud to present Ashley with the President's Medal for Outstanding Graduate Student and to recognize her accomplishments as recipient of the Chancellor's Award for Student Excellence. Congratulations. And Ashley will now deliver the student address.
Good evening and welcome, faculty, staff, family, friends, and of course, graduates. Congratulations, class of 2016. Here we are at the end of our graduate studies. Some of us feel the sense of mastery, while others aren't so eager to wear that label, because with mastery comes a sense of responsibility, a sense of duty. Master's studies require development of unique attention to detail that I don't think will ever go away, as well as the accumulation of unusual pieces of information, such as spending so many late nights at the library that you know when they restock the vending machine. But I think we can all agree that the most important aspect of our education isn't the quirky tendencies we developed or the knowledge of vending machine schedules. So, being one of the English teachers in the room, I want to do an activity. There's no submission, there's no grading, but just one short reflection. Let's all stop and reflect about our first day in college, our first semester of freshman year, our first moment in a college classroom. For some, like me, it might make you cringe. But yet here I am, ready to share, because, well, good teachers always model first, but also because, though this journey to this point was long and rocky and sometimes embarrassing, it has been completely worthwhile. I'm not talking about the knowledge we've gained, but rather the transformation we've experienced. The most important aspect of our education, the most meaningful part of this journey, is the individual transformation we feel and embrace, and the incredible people who helped guide this transformation. As a freshman, I'd race to each class, but not out of excitement, but rather in hopes of finding a seat in the furthest row, trying to continue to absorb my identity into the back wall. My freshman mind was also racing throughout every class, and not because of the intriguing discussions, but rather because of my fear to speak, and the shaking I'd feel every time I tried to raise my hand, the shaking in my voice as I tried to share my opinions, the shaking that I was certain that everyone else noticed. I was sure everyone else could sense that I didn't belong. I knew I didn't belong in the class. I didn't belong in college. I only saw the confidence and superiority of those around me. And so, it was my own self-doubt that suffocated my will to speak. I never said a word. But then, I had this one professor. Here was a professor from the Emerald Isles, gallivanting throughout the room, singing lyrics to the Doors as he discussed Alice's fall down the rabbit hole. His lecture was brilliant and intriguing and left me wondering how well he would do on a round of Jeopardy. He inspired me, and soon I went home to my parents one night and said, "I think I'm going to Ireland, and the deadline is tomorrow." We all have that one person, that one professor, the one we call on to give us perspective, the one who became more than a teacher, our mentor. And this mentor has stayed with me all these years. 7 years ago, I told my parents, "I think I'm going to Ireland, and the deadline is tomorrow," transformed to, "I'm going to Rwanda, and I'm buying my ticket tomorrow." And, well, now, I'm moving to Rwanda as one of 6 Fulbright scholars in Buffalo State's history. I had a reason to be in that classroom. We all did. A reason to transform. And now we all have a reason to be here in this room at the end of our graduate studies. We only become who we are because of the people who surround us, the people who believe in us. Whether this be family, friends, or the mentors we've gained here at Buffalo State, they've made us who we are. They have witnessed our difficulties, our breakdowns, our successes, and sometimes more failures than we'd like to be known. But it is our community that shapes us. So, while we're in this reflection, there's something I'd like to tell our more tentative freshman selves, a proverb that reflects our transformation over all these years. It reads, "The master has failed more times than the beginner has even tried." I'll repeat that. The master has failed more times than the beginner has even tried. Failure is inevitable, but with perseverance we can overcome. That is a true path to mastery. The beginner is out there, just waiting to develop the confidence to try. There will always be that girl in the back row. It is now our job to find her. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashley, for those inspiring words, and congratulations again on your well-deserved recognition today. I'd now like to invite Alumni Association President Richard DiGiulio to join me for the presentation of the Distinguished Alumna Award. Will Catherine Collins please come forward? Catherine Fisher Collins was elected to represent the 8th Judicial District of the New York State Board of Regents by the New York State Legislature for a 5-year term beginning March of 2015. She graduated from Buffalo State in 1975 with a Bachelor's of Science degree in Vocational Technical Education. She went on to earn a nursing degree from Trocare College and a Master of Science degree in Allied Health Education, Evaluation, and Curriculum from the University of Buffalo, where she also completed the School of Nursing's Nurses Practitioner Program and earned her Doctorate of Education degree in 1990. She holds 3 certificates in health education and is a graduate of England's Oxford University Women's Roundtable. Dr. Collins served on the Buffalo School Board and the New York State Commission of Corrections Medical Review Board, the first nurse appointed to this position, which she held for more than 5 years. She is the author of 13 books on women's issues and social justice, and is a mediator for community dispute resolutions. She also hosted a health service information program on WIVB-TV for 3 years. And 2011 launched Women's Health with Dr. Catherine Collins, which airs on WWWS-AM 1400. She has exhibited a quest for lifelong learning and has dedicated herself to community service, receiving over 50 awards and honors. She has spearheaded community initiatives such as Project Love and Hope for Homeless Children that serves children in New York and in Massachusetts, Connecticut, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Virginia, and Washington, D.C. Dr. Catherine Fisher Collins, your alma mater, is truly proud of your many education and professional achievements and of your service to the community. We are extremely proud and honored to present to you the 2016 Buffalo State College Distinguished Alumna Award. Dr. Collins will now deliver the commencement address.
It's all yours.
President Conway Turner, Alumni Association's president, members of the College Council, conveners of this master ceremony, distinguished members of Buffalo State faculty, staff, and administration, and of course, the parents, family members of Buffalo State graduate class of 2016. Let's give them a round of applause. Good evening. Thank you so much for inviting me to take part in today's celebration. I know how much this day means to all of you, especially the graduates and their families. Everyone in this room Every graduate came here by a different path, but you all had two things in common: purpose and perseverance. Maybe you had to work a full-time job while taking classes, as I did. Maybe you had kids to raise or family to take care of, as I did. Maybe you had academic or physical challenges to overcome or financial hardship. Whatever challenges you faced, you overcame them. You had a purpose to get an education, and you persevered. You got that education. And in the process, you developed strength and you developed character. Nearly 70 years ago, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. wrote an exceptional, powerful essay called The Purpose of Education. In it, Dr. King wrote, "Education must enable one to sift and weigh evidence, to discern the true from the false, the real from the unreal, and the facts from fiction. The function of education, therefore, is to teach one to think intensively and think critically. But education which stops with efficiency may prove to be the greatest menace to society. We must remember that intelligence is not enough. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education." Clearly, he lived those words. The essay first appeared in the Morehouse College school newspaper. King was 18 years of age, Morehouse College Junior, when he wrote that. 18 years, let me repeat that, 18 years. Some people apparently find their genius at an earlier age than others. Like Dr. King, you're sitting here today because you have character and perseverance. A lot is being made these days about the power and importance of grit. Notice psychologist Angela Duckworth has written a widely popular bestseller on the subject, noting that the secret of outstanding achievement is not necessarily a natural God-given talent or intelligence, but rather a special blend of passion and persistence that she calls grit. I agree, and every one of you here today is a testament to the power of determination and stick-to-it attitude. I have a deep and abiding love for education and lifelong learning. I hold undergraduate degrees that you just heard. I'm going to repeat them. Undergraduate degrees from Trocare College in nursing, a bachelor's of science degree from State University, this college, which I love, from the Vocational Technical Education Department. I also hold a doctorate degree from SUNY in education administration and a master's in allied health education and curriculum development as well. I also graduated from the School of Nursing as a nurse practitioner program, and I hold several certifications. I'm not telling you about my degrees to boast, but simply to explain just how much of my life I have devoted to my studies. The way I see it, when you stop learning, you stop living. These degrees and that learning have opened countless doors and countless opportunities for me over the years. They've allowed me to work in a variety of fields, each one different and exciting. I've written over 12 books. I've launched a radio show. I've had positions in healthcare administration and education. Too many here to mention. Maya Angelou said that you can only become truly accomplished at something you love. Don't make money your goal. Instead, pursue the things you love doing and then do them well, that people can take their eyes off of you. This point is, I've never stopped learning, growing, both personally and professionally. And since last year, I've had the honor and privilege of serving on the New York State Board of Regents representing Western New York. In that position, I have the opportunity to establish educational policy for all of New York State. It is truly the culmination of a lifetime spent in education. Again, I'm sharing this not to boast, but rather to tell you what I think you already know, that great things can happen, your life dreams can be realized when you study hard and when you work hard. And it's so clear to me that you all are well on your way to realize your dreams. You know, I couldn't have made it through all of that schooling if it weren't for the inspirational, life-changing teachers, professors, and mentors I was so lucky to have over the years. I've heard Jeffrey Canada, the great education reformer who founded the Harlem Children's Zone, say that success can be found at the intersection of what you are best at and what the world needs most. All of those great teachers who inspired and supported me along the way found their intersection of success helping me and countless others to succeed. They helped me get that true education that Dr. King wrote about. I know that many, though not all of you, are pursuing careers in education. While not all of you will be teachers, all of you can be citizens with a sense of purpose. You have all seized the opportunity to advance your education and to strengthen your skills. Now you can help someone start down that road towards greater opportunities. No matter what you do, no matter where your intersection lies, in business, public service, or healthcare, or education, remember that character that Dr. King spoke of. Live it in everything you do. If you do that, when you return here to Buffalo State College one day as an alum, you'll be able to look back not only on your personal and professional achievements, but on the legacy of contributions to the broader community. In my role as regents, I see every day the need for that kind of engagement and that kind of citizenship. I see every day the need for people like all of you graduates to become the role models and mentors for young people who have gotten off track. And sadly, too many have gotten off track. Too many drop out of school, too few graduates, and those who do graduate, too few have the knowledge and skills they need to succeed in life after high school. About a decade ago, the Regents tried to address the crisis in unprepared and underprepared students by embarking on an ambitious reform agenda. The intent of that reform was certainly an admirable one, to make certain that every student in New York State graduates high school ready to take on the rigors of college and careers. But it quickly became apparent that the implementation was not successful. And as I think you know, there was a great deal of pushback from educators and parents throughout the state. And so my colleagues on the board and I am working very hard to get it right this time. One of the very unfortunate outcomes of that struggle over education reform was that teachers were made to feel they were under attack, that their worth and their value were being called into question. The Regents and I are greatly concerned about this backlash against teachers. Simply put it, the anger is misdirected. Every one of us should understand that no school-based factor is more important to a student's success than the quality of his or her teacher. Is really as straightforward as that. So, as the Regents and I work to ensure that we make the right changes so that we can provide our schools with nothing but the best prepared, the best supported teachers. We want you to stay here in New York State. We want you to teach our children and run our schools. I'm not overstating when I say that the very future of New York State depends on it. There is no doubt that the first few years after graduation can be a challenge, but I know that the education you've received here and the challenges you have overcome to get an education have prepared you well because you've persevered through those challenging times. I mentioned earlier those obstacles that many of you face. Some of you are a little older than a typical student. You've come back to school after working for a while, raising kids. Some of you are changing careers. Some of you couldn't afford to go to grad school right away. You've been tested and challenged, and you have made it. You survived these challenges. You've come away stronger and wiser than before. Today is a great accomplishment. Don't forget to thank your parents, your family, your teachers, and God, as I did every day and still do. Thanks anyone who helped you get that education. So thank you for honoring me with the privilege of addressing you on this day, your day. I'm supposed to try to inspire you, but you inspire me. You inspire me to go back to Albany with my fellow Regents and keep on fighting to make sure that every student in New York State has the same opportunities to sit where you are today. Thank you. Thank you. Think of the legacy you want to have when you return here 20 or 30 or 50 years from now. Think of the things that you want to do in the world and for the world between now and then. Think of the young people in your family, in your community. Think of all of the people that you can guide. Think of where your talents match what the world needs most, and then start building that legacy. Congratulations, class of 2016. God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you. Thank you.
That was great. Thank you for those inspiring words, Catherine. Today is an important day for all of our graduates, and it's a Buff State tradition to recognize those who have encouraged and assisted today's graduates. Now we can ask the family members, spouses, special friends, and anyone else that wants to stand up so that the faculty, the staff, and the graduates may applaud you in this very important day. Please stand. Thank you. And now, graduates, please take this opportunity to recognize the faculty and the staff who encouraged and assisted you every day along the way. Everyone want to stand, faculty and staff, please. Thank you very much. At this time, I call upon Provost Perot to present the candidates for degrees and the certificates.
Before presenting the candidates for degree conferral, I would like to acknowledge anyone with us today who put themselves in harm's way in service to our country. Many of our military and veteran graduates can be identified by the red, white, and blue honor cords they wear with their regalia today. Would all members of the graduating class who are current or former members of the armed forces please stand? Thank you. Would all the current and former members of the armed forces in the audience please also stand and join our military and veteran graduates? On behalf of everyone in the auditorium today, we thank you for your sacrifice and your service. Thank you. As Chief Academic Officer of Buffalo State College, it is my duty to certify that each candidate has upheld the academic standards of this institution and that they fulfilled the requirements for the degrees and certificates for which they are recommended. I do so now and call upon Dean Kevin Raley, Dean of the Graduate School, to present the candidates for degrees and certificates.
When the candidates hear their respective degrees announced, I ask them to rise and remain standing. Master of Science in Education. Master of Science. Master of Arts. Remain standing, please. Thank you. Master of Public Administration. Master of Music Education. And last but certainly not least, will the candidates for the Certificates of Advanced Study please rise. Madam President, it gives me great pleasure to present these candidates and those in absentia who have completed the requirements of the respective curricula.
Thank you, Provost Perot and Dean Raley. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the State University of New York, and subject to the completion of the requirements set by the faculty, I hereby confer upon the graduate degree or certificate of advanced study for which you have been recommended. We are pleased to present a diploma to you and all the rights, privileges, and honors pertaining thereto. Graduates, please be seated. Will our readers, Roger Feinstein and Tom Kohler, please come forward? And marshals, please escort the graduates forward so that you may hood the master's graduates and present those receiving certificates of advanced study with their academic stoles.
Presenting graduates from the School of the Professions. Okay. try that again. Presenting graduates from the School of Education. Hooding for the Department of Adult Education, Associate Professor Jerry Hura. Also hooding for the Department of Adult Education, Assistant Professor Andrea Nikashur. Susan Schmidt. Janita Lynn Everhart. Diane Clark. Benita B. Stafford. Jillian Marie Blake. Ashley Ellis. Taylor Haynes. Hooding for the Career and Technical Education, Associate Professor Steve Mako. Eric Fiorello. Samuel Leone. Ashley Lipka. Kara Weber. Hooding for the Department of Elementary Education and Reading, Assistant Professor Dr. Jing Zhai. Also hooding for the Department of Elementary Education, Associate Professor Reva Fish. Soyan Gu. Hooding for the Department of Elementary Education and Reading, the Woods Beal Endowed Chair for Urban Education, Jawan Hunter. Christine Kling. Megan Granditz Mahan. Ariana March.
Rachel Burke. Whitney Yorio. Casey Polenkars. Lauren Metzen. Allison Riggi. Ashley Jane Austin. Alyssa Reynolds. Danielle Gorney. Casey Orth. Lucy Perry. Courtney Avanetsky. Victoria Arthur. Amanda Stelterman. Caitlin Kurtz. Megan Sears. Victoria Fleming. Bryce Princeton Marshall. Hooding for Educational Leadership, Associate Professor Nancy Ciccola. Gina Gazdalski. Hooding for the Department of Exceptional Education, Professor Kevin Miller. Tabitha Lobel. Amanda Farabend. Stephanie Ann Hollis. Catherine Kelly. Molly Gowan. Aaron Deutschman. Amy Perkins. Ashley Prince. Larissa Kimball. Melissa Kosalski. Jennifer Southworth. Amanda Dopp. Nicole Klepsaddle. Brittany Benton. Jacqueline Foote. Morgan Billai. Wendy Howlett. Putting for the Department of Exceptional Education, Associate Professor Dr. Teresa Jancic. Samantha Bowes. Devin Grau. Jessica Andriach. Stephanie Schwartz. Nicole Dixon. Jacqueline Phillips. Chantel Milton. Hooding for the Program of Literacy Specialist, Associate Professor Dr. Kelly Garris York. Matthew Keneally. Eileen Hinton. Thank you. Sarah Ketzel. Stephanie Eichinger. Anna Giangreco. Rebecca Metz. Nicole Adamson. Crystal Holmes Smith.
Hooding for the International Center for Studies and Creativity, Associate Professor Dr. Susan Keller Mathers. Also hooding for the International Center for Studies and Creativity, Lecturer Mike Fox. James Kowal. D. Langenkamp. Sadana Brown. Shanika Latty. Judine Griffith. Daryl Roberts. Jennifer Babcock. Trevor Tomian. Kimberly Appleby. Kelly Aurelio. Susan Cerny. Beverly Weiss. Peggy Barber. Barnwell. Father Felix Kingsley Obilao. Lena Pugsley. Put in for the International Studies and Center for Studies and Creativity, Department Chair and Professor Dr. Gerard Puccio. Karina Loria. Molly Hollinger. You got it, baby. Miguel Anthony Pereira III. Put in for the International Center for Studies and Creativity, Assistant Professor Selchuk Akar. Sarap Odemar. Put in for the Department of Criminal Justice, Chair and Associate Professor James Sobel. Also put in for the Department of Criminal Justice, Assistant Professor Dae Young Kim. Magdalena Mapinga. Leslie Winicki. Let's try that again. Lindsay Winicki.
There we go.
Put in for the Department of Computer Information Systems, Professor Steve Garo. Also put in for the Technology Program, Department of Information Systems, Professor Ruth Gao. Donald Turner III. Emma Shack. April Du Bois. Jose Ignacio Medina. Sameya Kokmas. Meritath Pratiwi. Alicia Hackett. Aitina Farid Cook. Michael Baranich. put in for the Department of Higher Education Administration, Professor and Chair Kimberly Klein. Scott Silverman. Kevin Diver. Nicholas Susanna. All right. Oh,
yeah. Ahmed Danielle Islam. Pat Schindler. Vanessa Taylor. Keisha Brandy. Emily Buell. Bailey Horning. Dustin Raymond Gardner. Putting for the Department of Higher Education, Assistant Professor Amy Wilson. Hilda Meyer Post. Libby Pazanek. Daryl Porter. Gail Reno. Mercedes Diamond Brooks. Siobhan Sykes Ramadan. Lindsay E. Dotson. Jeffrey J. Sharoon. Caitlin Janik. Rebecca Catalano. Christina Valentin. Erica Chaviano. Hooding for the Department of Higher Education, Assistant Professor Carmen McCallum. Chalice Capri Cooks. Samantha Santee. Sade Lanier. Denise Bach. Julian Augustin Cepeda. Geronimo Valcarcel. Keith Wolfgang Nunez. Alfred Akuoko Boateng. Mr. Mafoto. Mrs. Mafoto. Kenise Adams. Charleston Joseph. Clay Charles Grego Lopez. Hooding for the Engineering Technology Department, Associate Professor John Urshan. Manny Bellucci. Anthony Roth. Ahmed Jumjone. Daryl LaRocque. Melanie Bukowski. Jezawini Bahara. Haifa Barnawi. Hooding for the Department of Speech Language, the Chair and Director of Pathology, Constantine Dean Qualis. Also hooding for the Department of Speech Language Pathology, Assistant Professor Milo Maldonado. Corinne Marshall. Selena Krikovic. Bree Pizikevich. Natalie Cavallari. Marissa Caruso. Julie Mazur. Kayla Fielder. Brittany Philippe. Ashley Nans. Melanie Dorosky. Taylor McGraw. Courtney Playtech. Christine Sowinski.
presenting graduates from the Graduate School. Pudding for the Department of Multidisciplinary Studies, Associate Professor Reva Fish. Lori Graziano. Dominique Sosa. Pudding for the Program of Multidisciplinary Studies, Associate Professor Jane Cushman. Brooke Flanagan. Pudding for the Program of Multidisciplinary Studies, Assistant Professor Dr. Xing Zhao. Shang Li. Chu Wan. Pudding for the Program of Multidisciplinary Studies, Associate Professor of Economics and Finance and Coordinator of the Applied Economics Program, Victor Casper. Jessica Micha. Pudding for the Program of Multidisciplinary Individualized Studies, Assistant Dean and Program Coordinator, Dr. Kimberly Jackson. Alfred Haley. Amanda Quino. Davari Shadi Williams.
Thank you, Hydra.
Pudding for the Program of Multidisciplinary Studies, Public Relations Track, Associate Professor of Communication, Dr. Deborah Silverman. Vari Bittler. Patricia Jetty.
Tracy Fallon King, beautiful. Congratulations.
Tracy Fallon King. Lori Kaiser. Melissa Ruiz. Aja Session. Kiara Randall. Mishri Khan. Presenting graduates from the School of Arts and Humanities, pudding for the Department of Art Education, Chair and Associate Professor Alice Panassi. Close? Okay. Brianna Dilgarian. Caitlin Baichi. We'll do. Eleanor Byrne. Matthew Daggett. Adam Krutinger. Pudding for the Department of English, Associate Professor and Master of Arts Coordinator Jennifer Ryan Bryant. Also pudding for the Department of English, Associate Professor Dr. Peter Ramos.
Megan Clough. Hooding for the Department of English, Professor Amabel Twagali Mana. Maureen Ann Porter. Kimberly Gajewski. Hooding for the Department of English, Assistant Professor James Cerconi. Ashley Wezelak. Vanessa Ludwig. Lindsay Netto. Hooding for the Department of Modern and Classical Languages, Chair Mark Warford. Adriana Ditis. Hooding for the Program of Music Education, Associate Professor Rick Fleming. Kimberly Harrison. Joshua Pacino. Presenting graduates from the School of Natural and Social Sciences, hooding for the Department of Biology, Chair and Associate Professor Martha Skerritt. Hooding for the Department of Biology, Professor Chris Panuto. Raven Baxter. Hossein Benid. John Lang. Hooding for the Forensic Science Program of the Chemistry Department, Professor Gregory Ebert. Also hooding for the Forensic Science Program of the Chemistry Department, Chair and Professor M. Scott Goodman. Leanne Garozzo. Hooding Danielle Precourt. Anjuli Bhandari. Kaylee Beamisdurfer. Putting for the program of Great Lakes Ecosystem Science, Professor Kelly Frothingham. And also, hooding for the program of Great Lakes Ecosystem Sciences, Research Sciences, Knut Malev. Anthony Severe. Hooding for the History and Social Studies Education Department, Professor and Chair Andrew Nichols. Joseph Tusseri. Eric Raymond. Joseph J. Cucciardo, Jr. Hooding for the Department of Mathematics, Associate Professor Jodell Magner. Also hooding for the Program of Professional Applied and Computational Mathematics, Associate Professor Shazi Bayram. Alexis Mikulski. Jeffrey Weiss. Siyong Song. Tianchang Zhao. Hooding for the Program of Museum Studies, Associate Professor and Director Cynthia Konides. Christine Ann Parker. Danielle D'Elia. Salim Lanzat. Alyssa Frigi. Emily Sims. Deirdre Reynolds. Isabel Celeste Bateson Brown. Amanda Niemi. Brittany Jimerson. Nicole Congella. Amazetta High. Hooding for the Masters of Public Administration and Nonprofit Management, Assistant Professor Ada Cisse. Hooding for the Masters of Public Administration and Nonprofit Management, Assistant Professor Suparna Soni.
Heather LaForme. Kimberly Remda. Evelyn Jones. Naima Yancey. Crystal Collado. Jolaine Haber. Corina Murphy. Marissa Nold. Kimberly Jernan.
German. Let's try that again.
Kimberly German.
There we go.
Alaska Mackinus. Kayla Carrasquillo. Put in for the Master of Public Administration. Let's try that again. Put in for the Master of Public Administration and Nonprofit Management, Professor Lori Bonanno. William Langer. Habuk Masham. Edmund Barfour. Esperanza Regamba. Christine Matos. Put in for the Department of Earth Sciences and Science Education, Associate Professor Joseph Zawicki. Stephen Dempsey. Jacqueline Parenti. Eric Troutman. Shannon Graves. Siki Lee. Nicholas Bacon. Ashley Kuma.
That was great. Now we're all going to sing the alma mater with a lot of vigor, followed by the presentation of the class. At that point, we're going to ask all of you in the audience to stay in your seats, enable the graduates and the platform party to exit. We have to keep the doorways clear, and I appreciate your help in that. So please wait to exit, meet the graduates outside the sports arena, and join us for a reception in the Campbell Student Union. You will find the lyrics of the alma mater, Our Finest Hour, on the inside front cover of your program. After that's done, the graduates will remain standing for the presentation of the class. And now please stand, join the alumni of Buffalo State College. Today's graduates and members of the Buffalo State Chamber Choir and singing the college alma mater as loud as you can.
Graduates, please remain standing. I have one last duty, which will conclude our 2016 graduate commencement ceremony. Families, friends, distinguished guests, it is my honor to present to you the Buffalo State graduating class of 2016.